There's a big difference between a calendar that is full and a calendar that is functional. And it all starts with these 5 Google Calendar tips for 2026. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodi and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tons of tech tips and Google content just like this. And calendar chaos is so last year. Because if you can organize your calendar, you can organize your life. So here's how I organize Google Calendar for peak optimization of my time. First, I want to quickly mention here off the top that this calendar view can be customized to what you want. So before we get into my 5 Google Calendar organization tips, I prefer this weekly view of my calendar. It's from Sunday through Saturday, but you can change your GCal view anytime by clicking the drop down near the top right and then selecting your preferred view. You can select from day, week, month, year, schedule, or 4 days. And I want you to take note of the keyboard shortcuts listed to the right, because these are going to save you time in Google Calendar when you're toggling between your preferred views. Now that your view is set just how you want it, the first way I organize my Google Calendar is to create and add separate calendars, all viewable right inside my main GCal. So on the left here, you're gonna notice I've got a whole whack of calendars going on. Now these are other calendars I've enabled or added. So you can create a calendar for pretty much anything you'd like. To do so, next to the other calendars, just click that plus symbol to add other calendars. Then click create new calendar. Here, let's give your calendar a name. So for this example, I'm gonna just call this special occasions. Now in the description, I would make a note here of what I'm keeping track of with this calendar. So if you were creating, say, you know, like a child's sports schedule, you could be like, oh, this is Kylie's hockey, and you could put that info in here. Now, when you're all done, click on create calendar. If you want to share your calendar, you're going to click on it in the left bar and then select share with specific people or groups. This helps you stay even more organized with your family or team or whatever it might be. Then you just add these people via their emails and you'd click on send. Now, whoever you share to will have access to that same calendar in their GCal. Now, once you create this new calendar, it's going to be found on that left-hand menu in GCal underneath My Calendars. So to show or hide the calendar events on your actual calendar, you'll just click on the calendar name to toggle it on or off at any time from here. Now you can also edit the calendar's name at any time. And for this, we're gonna once again click that 3-dot menu icon next to the calendar. We'll click on settings and sharing, and then we'll simply change the name up at the top. Now I'm gonna go back out here in the top left to my GCal, because you might notice that I've got the Habs schedule on my Google Calendar. Now this is because I've added it as a calendar of interest, which is just so awesome. So click on that plus symbol again by other calendars. And this time let's click on browse calendars of interest. Not only will Google Calendar pull your contacts' birthdays and regional holidays, which by the way, you can use the drop-down menu to pull from a list of holidays around the world, which is so neat. You can also browse and add calendars for things like religious holidays and sports schedules. So for what I did was in the hockey dropdown, I selected the National Hockey League and then I toggled on the Montreal Canadiens calendar. So you can toggle on multiple calendars here, by the way. Now back in my GCal, you can see all the other calendars I've added. So I've got Canadian holidays, US holidays, Montreal Canadiens schedule, RIP Arizona Coyotes. Devastating. And then this one here is my husband's calendar that he shared with me. And yes, you can change the color of any calendar by clicking that 3-dot menu icon and choosing a new calendar color. And speaking of changing the calendar color, you might have noticed I'm a big believer in color blocking Google Calendar. What can I say? I'm a visual learner. And color blocking is a quick way to tell which client or project or calendar an event belongs to. You can set the color of an event when you're creating it, of course. So clicking over the color option when you're actually creating that event initially is going to allow you to select both the calendar and the color. So I'm going to close this and show you here that I've got my GCal colors organized first by my clients. So that way I can tell, bang, at one glance, the color of the task, which client this task is for, if that makes sense. Now I also color code by the task itself. So I know, as an example here, my editing tasks are always in gray. So I know at a real quick glance that this is an editing task for my YouTube content. But you can color block GCal for whatever works for you. So is it by client, per project, per task. Whatever works for you is what you can do here. And you can also change the color of an event after it's made as well. So simply right-click on the event and pick your desired color. And by the way, you're gonna know which events originated from your primary calendar because you're still gonna have your primary calendar color on the left side of the event. So see here how I make all my YouTube edit tasks stand out in gray, as I mentioned? Well, on the left of that event, it's this deep teal, which is my primary calendar color. And you're gonna notice that for every single one of my events on my calendar that's tied to my primary calendar, regardless of the color blocking that I've assigned it. Another nice visual cue. But you can set custom colors as well, which is really nice. So besides those default options, and that's exactly what I did for my primary calendar. So click on that three-dot menu icon in the right of the calendar that you want to change the color for. Then click the plus symbol under the default colors. Here you can scroll through the color slider or add your custom color hex code. So you could add a brand color here for a specific brand calendar, or if you're organizing per client, you can put their exact brand color in here. I just love this. By the way, if you want even more helpful tips on how to organize Google Calendar or how to save time in GCal, you can click up here to watch that, or I have a ton of Google Calendar content listed for you in the description below. Seriously, it's a little psychotic. But now that your Google Calendar looks like a thing of beauty, let's have it function like a thing of beauty. And the third way I do this is by using the repeat functionality. Why continuously create the same event over and over and over again? We are way too busy for that. So the first Monday of every month is a payday for a contractor. So let's click to create an event. And we'll set this Pay Jenny event to repeat on the first Monday of every month by clicking on the Does Not Repeat option. You don't have to set a time, by the way. So if you click to enable all day, it's gonna sit up at the top here. But you do have a bunch of preset options like weekly, monthly, and things like that. Or you can select custom and choose your custom repeat schedule. So I've selected the first Monday of every month. Now remember, you can assign a calendar color here as well, but I'm gonna click on save, and there we go. This has now been added to my calendar just as requested. You can literally set repeating events for anything you want in GCal. And the cool thing with these recurring events in GCal is that you can always edit a singular event, a standalone event in that string of recurring events, or you can have your edit reflect all future events. So let's click to edit this podcast publish event. And here I can update the event title if I need to, or I can add some event details. Now, when I click save, it's gonna ask me if I wanna make changes to just this event or all future events. So the same goes for if you want to delete a recurring event for a particular week, but leave it intact for future dates. Super helpful. So you can reflect those changes to only that particular event if you want. And if you're liking this video so far, please remember to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more content just like this. If you haven't already, I cannot believe we are over 100,000 strong. And this is kind of like a random side note, but now while I'm on this thought, should I be doing a giveaway? Maybe when I hit 150K. So put your ideas for what you want to see me give away in the comments below, and real ideas only. All right, my fourth tip for optimizing Google Calendar is to customize your notifications. So seriously be thinking about if and when you want to be notified about calendar events. First, you can adjust notifications on a calendar basis or per calendar event basis. So let's start with notifications on a per calendar basis. You can click on the three-dot menu icon to the right of the calendar and click into the setting and sharing again. Now from here, click on event notifications, and for my calendar, I've got the default set to 10 minutes in advance. Now here, you can change the notification type and time to whatever works for you. You can also completely delete the notifications for events on this calendar altogether, or you can add additional notifications for events on this calendar. Now the all day event notifications are these events that live on top of your day. Now remember, I'm gonna show you what this had looked like back in my calendar here. It looks like this, where you can add an event at the top of the day without a specific time slot. So this is great for birthday reminders, by the way. I use it all the time. I have a birthday calendar. But moving back into our all day event notification setting, here you can see for my personal calendar, I don't like having any notifications on for all day events. You can simply add a notification here if you prefer. Other notifications are for things like changes to events, canceled events, event responses, and a daily agenda email. Now you can simply toggle from email to none if you don't wish to receive email notifications here. And as I mentioned, you can adjust notifications on a per event basis as well. So for this, you're gonna click on the event, click on edit, And from here, you would adjust the default notification. The same options apply here, where we can adjust the type of notification and the time, or hit the X to delete the notification for this particular event altogether. And the fifth way I organize Google Calendar is to set up multiple time zones. This is a massive time saver as well for those of us that work across multiple time zones. Ooh, super helpful. So by default, Google Calendar will display the time zone that you're in. Now, if you click on the settings gear icon in the top right and select settings, you can then click on time zone on the left-hand side. Right away, you're gonna notice that I've got two default time zones that I've set up for my Google Calendar. Now here you're gonna be able to select an additional time zone from the drop-down menu, and you can even label the time zone however you'd like, which is exactly what I did. So now back in Google Calendar, you're going to have your local time zone, but then you're also going to have your secondary time zone set here too. It's a wonderful Google Calendar organization tip. So that's how to optimize your Google Calendar. And hopefully with those five tips, you've gone from overwhelmed to organized. And now I want to hear from you. How do you organize your Google Calendar? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or you can leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Google Calendar content. You know you wanna. Thanks for watching. See you next time.